We're back with the Senate President and the continuation of the OTR Pop Quiz. First one of 2019, by the way. It's a distinctive honor, by the way. All right, here's question three.
Honored.
And the Massachusetts State House is considered a masterpiece of what type of architecture? I'll give you multiple choice again. Is it brutalist? And oh, by the way, that is an architecture style. Is it brutalist? Is it federal? Or is it Greek Revival?
Greek Revival.
It's federal.
Federal.
Oh, federal.
Because the Doric columns are Greek.
Are Greeky,
aren't they?
Kind of. Yeah. The columns, right.
Okay.
All right, here's the final question, and this is about your hometown of Ashland. The original start line of the marathon was in Ashland, and it moved to Hopkinton in 1924. And why was it moved? We have multiple choices for you. Was it to conform to the new Olympic standard for distance? Was it concerns over road conditions? Was it because Hopkinton petitioned the state legislature?
It's A, but also George Brown of Hopkinton.
Excellent.
Took over the marathon that year, and he lives in Hopkinton. He lived in Hopkinton.
So it's A, but a little bit of C.
So it's A with a little
bit of C thrown in there.
A little bit more trivia there.
That's very good. You obviously know
your stuff when it comes to the marathon. So one of the first things Beacon Hill did after they got back from the holiday was to get a big pay raise. You yourself got $11,000 plus boost. Is this justified, considering that politicians haven't really done anything yet, and all they've done is make promises?
Well, it's the time under the Constitution that pay raises are granted. It's the governor that does the base pay, looking at the formula there's a general guideline. So that's when it's always done. There have been some years of late where we've gotten zero increase, or we've actually gotten cuts to our pay as well that most folks may not be aware of. So under the Constitution, that's when it's time for that to be given. And so that's what we did.
And you'll be taking the pay raise?
Yes.
And do you think that it is that most voters would agree that this is the right thing to do, considering many others are just beginning to get back to work again?
I believe that when I go out in my district and people heard in the past of what I used to make, they would say, Karen, you know, you probably aren't even making minimum wage here. So I believe that the legislature, the reps, the senators, you know, are really dedicated, hardworking public servants, just like the staff of the State House and all the administration. I mean, people are committed and dedicated to making Massachusetts better and keeping us move forward. So.
You were, is it fair to say you were largely elected because Stan Rosenberg was forced to resign as the Senate President? That began the sequence of events that has led to where you are right now. The chamber was in chaos for months. So the question is, what assurances can you give Senate staffers, lobbyists, viewers at home that there's no more subject to threats and intimidation by anyone connected to your Senate?
Well, we had a big working group doing a lot of work and looking at our policies. We had updated our policies on harassment and other issues every 2 years, but we looked at it again last year. We had a working group look at the issues. We are in the process of, we contracted with a consultant to do a sexual harassment climate survey. It would be anonymous, and so have anybody staff and senators and lobbyists and visitors fill out the form. We will do a lot of outreach. I want to know what's going on in the Senate. It has to be a respectful, welcoming, diverse body that not only wants to have the diversity but celebrates it.
Which is recovering from the Rosenberg episode, right?
Right. I believe the Senate is moving forward. I really do. I think that people are excited about the new session. I think there's a lot of issues that people want to tackle and are looking forward to the new year.
We can't let you go without making mention of the 18-month, $22 million renovation to the Senate chamber, which I understand is gorgeous. I haven't seen it myself.
Spectacular.
So I guess a lot of voters, you can take a look at it.
Yeah.
This is some of the video from the new chamber. But what does the average voter get out of this when you spend as much money as you do on something like this?
This is a historical building. It still blows me away that this is where I go to work, actually. It's a living museum. I believe it is one of, if not the oldest, state houses in the country. And the architecture is magnificent. First of all, it's something that it's a legacy for not only us, but our future generations to make sure that it's kept up and it's where visitors can come and be proud of. It also needs to be a safe environment. I know when I was in the House 1 year ago, there was a light fixture that fell. In the Senate, the summer before the renovation started, people were standing near one of the doors and a light fixture literally that was rusted out fell. We haven't kept up with that at all. And I think that we owe it to not only our current Massachusetts residents, but our future generations. It's beautiful. It is a museum.
But I noticed that the style hasn't changed, and it really pretty much looks like what it did when it was first renovated many, many years ago.
From 1896, right. 97, yeah, yeah. The colors and everything, we tried but to keep it.
But that's part of the charm.
Right, although the difference that we did do, I left two, there are two alcoves that the busts were not replaced. We are planning on putting one of Frederick Douglass. We have a quote from Frederick Douglass on the wall, wonderful. In line with having more diversity. Yeah. And the other one will be a woman of historical significance, possibly our own Abigail Adams.
Wonderful. Wow. Wonderful. It's great.
Right.
Great. Senate President Karen Spilka, great to see
you.
Happy New Year. Thanks for joining us on the record.
Happy, healthy New Year.
As we continue this morning, a new side of Senator Elizabeth Warren as she begins a run for the White House. Can she make it work? We'll talk about it in the OTR Roundtable.